So where are we going?
I don't want to give too much away, but things are going to get a little bit easier. That's all I'm going to say.
No more of that.
Shopping recently, and that means that I've walked past this place about a million times. And at first I was like, yeah, you know. Then I saw Cristiano Ronaldo, I was like, actually, you know, that's kind of a big deal. And then I saw that actually quite a few people were buying it, so I was like, okay, we'll make a video about it out of curiosity. We're not going to film any people, but we're going to take note of what they say, and then we'll come out and have a little chat about it afterwards. Shopping experience I've ever had. Yeah. Like, that shop had nothing about the product.
It's like they didn't want to talk about it. We did get a brochure.
To be fair, we're still going to go back and look at the science, because it could just be something that's really complicated that wasn't well communicated within the shop. We're going to have a look at the science for ourselves, get my whole database sorted, and we'll chat about it. I thought I would do an unboxing. For £230, which is about $300, this thing must be pretty damn legit. Oh, yes. So I actually tried to film the shop, but it was a bit awkward because there was no one in there, and there was nothing in there either. There was literally just the products, and then nothing about them, nothing, apart from a price. It was a bit like a museum. Even when I was asking them what it was, I wasn't getting clear answers. They even said they would have to email a brochure, and I was like, well, that's just really bizarre. Long story short, I still bought the product, you know? So, joke's on me, really. It's waving at you. Okay. I need external help. I'm guessing that's where my abs are. I can only feel it in this one. That means I've got no other abs. It feels like, you know when you've got bubbles in your stomach? Feels like that. So one of the main reasons why I wanted to make this video was because I just wanted to know what it was for, because I feel like the product is quite ambiguous. It's aimed at the mass market, and which is why it's in Westfield. They've got Cristiano Ronaldo. So one of the things I kept asking was what it was for. All they kept coming back to me was, you're gonna get results. Are they fat loss? And they kept saying, no, not for fat loss. Is it for muscle building? No, it's not for muscle building, you'll just get toned. And they kept repeating toned and results. In essence, toned is lean body mass. There would be some muscle building even though they claim there's no muscle building, and there would be some fat loss even though they claim there's no fat loss with the product. Tone doesn't exist as something separate to those things. Basically, Cristiano Ronaldo has a toned body. So it's just very confusing. To be completely fair to one of the guys, he said that it's not to be used instead of training, and this should be used as kind of a supplement. Though he did say that you will get accelerated results, and he said it wasn't just for athletes, it was for everyone. So then I was like, okay, well, maybe the advert will help.
Body revolution.
All right, yeah, no, that didn't help. What about the website? I'm sure they'll have some references to scientific research. I'm on the website now, whilst I'm working out, highly multitasking, and I can see a quote from the man himself, Cristiano Ronaldo. Keep training, and I'm confident it will bring a revolution to your body. Outstanding performance is the result of daily training. It isn't magic, it's persistence. I don't really understand what that says. It's just so ambiguous. I just don't really know what the product is claiming to be. And I'm not saying that this is the case, but if money is involved, people are kind of willing to say anything or back anything. Or the other thing is that Cristiano Ronaldo could genuinely believe that it's working for him. But as a scientist, you can't really go off anecdote, and there's no world where Cristiano Ronaldo is training as he is now without EMS. So there's no parallel universe where you're comparing the two and keeping every single variable the same. And that's why randomized controlled trials exist, because you want to take out the effect of everything except EMS. So let's keep looking on the website to see if they've provided any of that key research that we're looking for. So we go down and I found Toshio Moritani. Hello. Also, that is some perfectly drawn diagrams. I don't think I've ever seen a whiteboard that perfect in my entire life. what's this sexy fella doing? We are now at some of the research, so verifying six pad effectiveness. So it's a bit confusing because he's comparing 20 hertz to other frequencies. It's just saying that it has a better frequency than other EMS instruments at different frequencies. It's almost like saying 6-inch heels are easier to run in or sprinting than 10-inch heels. It's just a weird kind of analogy trying to say that 20 hertz is more effective than like 80 hertz when we don't know if either of them are good. I'm still not convinced, even by a sexy Japanese scientist. So I found something that says EMS training for easy body toning. It also says that fast twitch muscle is easy to build. So it characteristically leads to a toned body if you train. It can easily produce a change in appearance, but where's the scientific backing, people? The focus is on the toning part, so more like appearance-based, just kind of aesthetics. This one is probably my favorite on the website. Nowadays, there are many people who, I don't know if I can say it seriously. Nowadays, there are many people who have a big, bulging stomach, even though the food intake of people in their 20s is lower than the post-war years. Professor Moritani states that muscles are the organs that burn the largest amounts of fat and sugar. Almost saying it like this product will help you build muscle, because otherwise why would he say it? So without ever really saying it, they are alluding to this product helping you to lose fat and build muscle. Oh, there's a little customer support thing. Oh my God, he's asking me for my name.
Natasha.
That's what Mario's godson keeps calling me. So we're chatting, and he gave me this claim about this test. So I was like, okay, cool, do you have the actual research, the paper? He just said, I'll just forward you to the escalation team. But in the meantime, I have a look at all these YouTube reviews. So again, like I'm actually not gonna look at the YouTube reviews because they're anecdotal, they're reviews, they might have been paid for, and there's also bias in there. If you've spent £230, you want it to work. Oh, now he's asking for an email address. I'm just gonna make one up. Let's see if I ever hear back from them.
We thought of life by analogy with a journey.
Right, oh, I need to get this thing off.
Which had a serious purpose at the end. You look like Cristiano.
What's that pose that he does? I've read many papers. Thousands. I've spent thousands of hours reading papers. I've never seen a research paper that is one side of A4 with four references. So first thing, this whole paper is about muscle exhaustion, but they never actually demonstrate that muscle exhaustion is linked to fat loss or muscle hypertrophy. They never demonstrate that in this paper. So it's a paper that's within the topic of electromyostimulation, but it's not actually demonstrating that whether you have this product, you will get the results that they're alluding to. So they got people to repeat strength moves, some with the EMS machine attached to them, some without, and then they wanted to look at how much their strength decreased. So people who had EMS, their strength decreased a lot more than people who didn't have EMS. So they were saying that if you use EMS, your muscles will be more fatigued. And they were saying that muscle fatigue was a good thing. If the results had been different and their strength had gone up, they could say that EMS improves your strength and then paint a whole picture that way. So the results could have painted six pad in a good light, whatever the outcome was. So now let's look at these four references. I can't keep going with the references. I'm gonna do my own research and then we'll come up to hopefully a better conclusion.
Oh!
What are you doing? Oh. Wait, show them the reaction.
Like, my body is like, look at it.
You need to calm down.
You've got me sat back like I'm in labor.
Okay, ma'am, I'm gonna have to ask you to give me one more push.
Don't lift my leg. No, it's not a game. These are my abs. Can you imagine if like a guy came up to you in the gym, just wearing one of these, had like a cute little crop on? You alright? Do you live around here? Or do you...
Why are you speaking so...
I'm just exhausted. Do you come here? Get me my crop top. Can you see?
I don't know, it's just focusing on my face.
Yeah.
I thought I could film this video in a full day. So I've been reading papers all night. You can probably tell from my eyes that they're like drooping. Overall, I feel like we're quite early on in this research. There's still a lot to be done. I'm gonna categorize it into two parts. So the first being on EMS and its effect on physical appearance. So muscle mass and fat loss, which together would be what people would typically define as toned. And then in the second I need to sleep after this. In the second one, I'm going to talk about performance. Now we're going to focus on EMS on physical appearance. First, we're going to look at muscle mass, and I'm going to break that down into immobile people and healthy people. So there is a lot of research that goes into looking at how EMS can help preserve muscle mass in immobile or partially immobile patients, those suffering from muscle atrophy or sarcopenia. And there's quite a good amount of evidence that suggests that in therapeutic uses, it can help muscle preservation. Here, the research has been done pretty well, and I'm pretty impressed with how in the medical grade instruments, there seems to be some really good evidence for preservation of muscle. So now looking at patients who are healthy and how EMS might increase their muscle mass, this is where I feel like it gets a lot less convincing. Once we get into that body of research, the results get really conflicting. This is why I was up all night. Wait, but this paper says it. But this paper says it. It was all really weird. So I'd say overall, I'm pretty underwhelmed with a lot of the research. There were quite a few conflicts of interest. It feels like this topic isn't highly funded. So companies like Compex will fund this kind of research, come out with positive results, and then kind of aggressively argue against why other people didn't get the same results as they did. I also felt like the methodologies generally were pretty incomplete. A lot of the trials weren't randomly controlled, they didn't have double blindedness? Yeah, they had poor controls, so compliance could have gone out the window. And I just had so many questions, like so many suspicious questions, I was like, this is weird. For one example, one of the papers had a control group which continued exercising, and then the other group was exercising with EMS. And in that control group, they were exercising as they had been before they put on body fat. So either they'd changed their diet up or something that would have made them gain fat. Anyway, going round and round in circles, and then I came across a few systematic reviews, kind of confirmed what I was thinking, because they realized that on average, a lot of the trials that had been done on EMS for fat loss and muscle mass had Pedro scores of 5. Really, you wanna be hitting at least 6 for it to be like a good quality trial. A lot of them were way below 6. And then the third thing, I just felt like they were taking their conclusions a step too far. So for example, taking measurements straight after EMS and assuming that that's a long-term outcome without actually demonstrating that. Overall, I feel like I'm quite underwhelmed, but it's kind of 50-50 in the body of research. If it does have an impact, then often the results are very slightly statistically significant, and the magnitude is not great. So I just wonder whether it's worth the actual money or actually wasting your time. Now looking at EMS for fat loss, again, I just feel like poor quality of studies and very mixed. Those that say that it can impact fat loss just have very low magnitudes of change. So in one example, they said it had a positive impact on fat loss, but in 54 weeks of patients doing EMS training, they noticed a 1.3% decrease in waist circumference. Now, I'm not saying this isn't true, but 1.3 is pretty small over 54 weeks. And a lot of the time, the equipment they're using is whole body EMS and not like the six pad that I have somewhere. And because they're using it under kind of medical conditions, the frequencies are a lot higher in those products compared to commercially available ones. So the two types of equipments aren't even that similar. So I don't even know if it's relevant to these commercial products. So now we're gonna look at EMS and the impact it has on performance. So here the research is focused on strength and power, focused on elite athletes. And I feel like the research here is pretty good. That was music to my eyes. And here they found that they could see changes in power within the magnitude of 5 to 15% over a few weeks of training with EMS. So that was quite good. A lot of the researchers came to the conclusion that those increases in strength were due to neural adaptations. These changes were happening without hypertrophy. And because of this research, it looks like quite a lot of athletes are adopting this technique to improve their performance. I've seen Usain Bolt using it. Cristiano Ronaldo might actually be using it. Don't know if he's using six pack, but he might be using EMS as a technology. But again, a lot of the testing is done under supervision with different equipment than what is being sold to us. So for example, in a lot of the studies, they're using EMS as whole body EMS, and they're doing it during training compared to the commercially available products, which are often more isolated and typically tell you not to train during the EMS period. So that's it. I feel like I can say with good confidence that EMS as a concept is good for therapeutic reasons and also to improve strength and performance in elite trained athletes. Now, I don't know whether that can really apply to the general population or whether those commercially available products are the same as those that are being tested. But for actual muscle hypertrophy and fat loss for the general population, that's where I'm super unconvinced. I'm not saying they don't work, I'm just saying that I can't say that they do work. Save your $300, go treat yourself with something cute, maybe some food, but not on one of these just yet. My eyes are kind of frazzled, so I'm gonna end it here. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please give me a big thumbs up. Please hit the subscribe button. Next week, I'll be in Sri Lanka with some of you guys. I love you, and I'll say goodbye. Bye.
What are you doing?
I'm training.